Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 2 of 7th Time Loop. So let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. Of course, they gotta show it one more time. Yes. Girl? Bye. He's so pretty, too. Like, oh my God. That was a pretty opening. See, Rishi, I don't think he has aims. Like, I mean, I think he just, you know, he liked what you did last week. So, you know, hey. Oh. Okay. You sure about that? How can you already be in love with her if you only just met her? What about her do you love? I wonder how this is gonna go. Yeah. I know. He really pretty. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, we can do that. I can do that. Poison? I mean, you wanted the guards to trust her, right? Because they all looking like, hey, yo, I don't know. Right. I mean, makes sense because, yes, not very trustworthy of her. Damn, that's beautiful. That's fine. I mean, that's a villa. That'd be paradise for me. He possibly could, because the fact is, you kind of gonna be marrying this man. That and maybe the smell in the air as well. Oh no. Yeah, let's just say a friend. Course of am. Oh. Yeah, and something about that is very interesting to him, and he likes it a lot. But he is just so hot. Honey, I don't think that's a lie. True, and that is scary. Okay, now my thing is, like, they are a really good-looking couple. Like, they look really good together. But I get it where Risha is basically like she's torn, and even with the fact she's like, I cannot read this man. I don't know what he's thinking, how he's going to get to the safe form of, him causing a war and such. And so I get the fact is even now where anytime when he says to her, oh, I'm in love with you, she don't believe that because it's like, how can you fall in love with someone immediately like me so quickly? But see, sometimes that's true with a guy or a girl. You never know. You can fall in love with somebody very quickly. And I get the fact that she's hesitant. I think if any one of us was in the same situation as her, especially living out six other lives and looking at this guy in a weird way, you'd be like, no. Big thought, no. But when he caressed her face, girl was just, she was weak. We all know. It's the touching of the face. It's using the right words and everything and knowing what the hell you want and how to say it and stuff. Folded in a nutshell, like in a heartbeat, sir, because he is oh so good. He know what he doing. He really do. I wish I was her for a moment, just a moment. Because I know my behind would fold in a heartbeat. But no, like, really, especially learning about her backstory with her mom and how her mom is like, I only want you to do this. Like, there is no time for academic studies or anything and wanting to be, like, independent. And that's what she wants, truly. Even in this, like, partnership slash marriage between her and Arnold, she still wants to be independent, even though she's like, no, I want to laze around and stuff. And do this, is that, and the third, but she still wants that independence. And I think a lot of us, we all feel that way in some shape or form. It's always a thing of once you have it and then you have to let it go, you crave that again. You like, yeah, you want your husband or your boyfriend or your girlfriend or your wife, like wine and dine, whatever, but you still crave that independency. You want to do things for yourself and you want to get things for yourself and not have to spend someone else's money for it. And when you do that, you feel oh so better. Best thing in the world, I'll tell you. But other than that, guys, that's my reaction towards episode 2 of Seventh Time Loop. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, it really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel and make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Sunday for episode 3. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.